on in and have some fun.
Come on.
So just come in and learn with us with the mouse in the house.
Woohoo!
With Carrie and Misha.
Yeah.
And Dino and Mariangela. So come on, young scientists. Come join the mouse in the house.
Uh-huh.
To the air, do you think it would float? Well, together with our studio members, we're going to learn about the remarkable art of floating ping pong balls. You will need some ping pong balls and a hairdryer. Now let's begin the experiment. Switch on the hairdryer, point it to the ceiling, and carefully put the ping pong ball in the stream of air. Hold the hairdryer very steady and watch as the ping pong ball floats in the stream of air. Wow! Look! It's floating! Now it's your turn. Carefully put the ping pong ball in the stream of air. Hold the hairdryer very steady and watch as the ping pong ball floats in the stream of air. Carefully move the hairdryer and watch how the ball moves, staying in the stream of air. That's cool! Look at that! It's floating! Let's try something more exciting. Try putting another ping pong ball in the stream of air and see what happens. Wow! They're both floating. Amazing!
How do the ping pong balls stay floating in the air of the hairdryer?
The air from the hairdryer flows around the outside of the ball, and if you position the ball carefully, the air flows evenly around each side. Gravity pulls the ball downward, while the pressure below pushes it upward. This means that all the forces acting on the ball are balanced, and the ball sits in mid-air.
When we move the hairdryer, why do the balls also move?
The fast-moving air from the hairdryer creates a low air pressure, and the surrounding high air pressure forces the ping pong ball to stay inside the column, making it easier to move the hairdryer around without losing control of the ping pong ball. Hey guys, come and join me as I show you how amazing floating can be. Come on! Skydiving is great fun, and you can perform aerial acrobatics and various maneuvers all in mid-air before pulling the ripcord of a parachute. Many people make their first jump with an experienced and trained instructor. This type of skydive is called a tandem skydive. Did you know that the world record in formation skydiving was done with 400 men? Wow! Look at that! Skydiving with a car! That's amazing! It's skydriving! Okay, back to solid ground now, and I'll see you back at my lab, kids! Today's green tip is... plant evergreen trees to protect your home from the chilling winter winds. Wow, that was great! Today, we learned how to make ping pong balls float, and also learned more about skydiving. But now it's done. See you later, kids.